So you're thinking about making that big move to New Jersey. Now, I don't know where you're coming from, if you're coming from Florida, if you're coming from California, if you're coming from New York. It all depends on where you're coming from. Now, there are parts of New Jersey. I think the majority of people have the wrong misconception that New Jersey is nothing but fist pumping, down the shore, chemical plant employee type of environment. Believe me, there are a lot of parts of New Jersey that you don't understand. Yes, we have New Jersey Shore. Yes, we have the Pine Barrens. Yes, we have the Highlands, which is northern New Jersey. And then we have that part of New Jersey that a lot of New York City commuters gravitate towards. And that's northern New Jersey, where my office is in Nutley and the surrounding area, which is about 13 miles from New York City. So that's another part of, we call that northern New Jersey. But when you think northern New Jersey, you're talking about the borderline of upstate New York, which probably is less convenient than living in North Jersey, which is more around like the suburbs of Newark, New Jersey, or Newark, as some people pronounce it. We call it Newark, New Jersey. Okay? So when you think of New Jersey that way, then we have southern New Jersey, which is the shore area, what you hear about a lot, like the Jersey Shore, which we have marvelous beaches, probably some that rival beaches that you've seen in California. So you California people, if you're thinking about moving to New Jersey, check out the Jersey Shore. But for most of the time, or for most part of it, people tend to move to New Jersey for one of several reasons. One being closer to family. They want to be closer to New York City because they have a job transfer, and there definitely is a part of New Jersey that's more convenient than other parts of New Jersey, like southern New Jersey, maybe 2.5 to 3 hours away from Manhattan. Way north New Jersey, maybe 2 hours from Manhattan. So it all depends. When you say New Jersey, don't lump New Jersey in all in one area. First of all, you have different counties of New Jersey. You have Essex County, Bergen County, Union County, Passaic County, Middlesex County, Somerset County. There's all different counties of New Jersey, depending on where you are. And then we have, again, northern, middle, and southern New Jersey. We don't really know where southern starts. We kind of think it's over the Driscoll Bridge. That's when we start heading down the shore. And that's what I forgot. There's a name that a lot of southern New Jersey call Bennies. They call northern New Jersey people Bennies that come down to the shore in the summertime and invade the people that live down there. Then we have, you go far down to Atlantic City. That's way southern New Jersey. You have Cape May, which is a beautiful town. That is way the tip of southern New Jersey. And then you have, if you go to the Highlands area, which starts somewhere around like Kinnelong, West Milford, and all the way up Franklin, Sussex County. You have Sussex County, which is way northern New Jersey. It's more rural. If you like more of like a lake type environment, then you're looking at like Sussex County, that area. So we have all different flavors of New Jersey, depending on what you're looking for. If you're looking to live in a log cabin in the woods, then I would say move to Sussex County. If you want something convenient to New York City, then I would say move to Nutley, New Jersey, or Newark, New Jersey. It all depends. If you want a more urban environment, Newark is your area. If you want a more suburban, then Nutley, Montclair, West Caldwell, those areas are more suburbs of New York City these days. Then you also have Jersey City, which is like an undeclared borough of New York City, which is 2 minutes away from New York City. So New Jersey has a big flavor. So if you're thinking about moving to New Jersey, give me a call. And if you want the Nutley Advantage, 862-228-0554.